cereal.
Okay, guys. You're right.
This one's real emotional.
Real emotional.
This one, guys.
Okay, here we go.
Lights, dim the lights. Yeah.
Coming back home to the place I belong. Coming back home.
Hey YouTube, Gloofist here again, and today, as promised, another tobacco review, and today it's going to be this Balkan Sasieni. This is actually made by, it says Sasieni London, New York. It's actually blended by Peter Stockerby. It's produced in Denmark. It's a ribbon cut, and it's a Balkan, as the name suggests. And the tobaccos, it consists of Latakia, Oriental Turkish, and Virginia. And this is a fresh tin, I actually haven't opened it yet, so I'll do that now. Oh, that's a lovely magic sound, isn't it? Is really packed in here. Look at this. Jeez. I know they go off weight. That's what it looks like. But as you can see, that's packed in there like a cake. By the time I fluff that out, that's going to be a good amount of tobacco. So with that in mind, it's actually a good value. Excuse me a moment. Smell this. Oh, that's nice. That's that's your typical Latakia smell, but you can certainly smell a bit of Virginia in there as well. Oh, that's fresh, but boy, that smells really nice. There's definitely some light colours in there and some darker ones, but smoking today in this is my 7LE Deluxe. It's proven to be quite a good wee smoker. It's just an old one that I'd done up, but for a long time I didn't even realise I owned one, so I was quite pleased. So let's get this underway anyway. Beautiful sunny day here again in Christchurch, New Zealand, and just this is the early autumn here, but we reached 31 degrees Celsius. You have to get your calculators out, whatever, to calculators, converters to what that is in Fahrenheit, but it's got to be high 90s. Absolutely stunning day. Do the tin note here. Everyone does, but anyway, I'm reading it as well. Original formula Balkan smoking mixture was created in London at the beginning of the century by the master of tobacco blenders, who first combined the aromatic pleasures of the choicest of Macedonia and Latakia leaf with the richness of old Virginia to give the pipe smoker an unrivaled smoking pleasure. Without further ado, let's thing flared up. It broke apart quite nicely. I mean, it's not a cake by any means, but it was like a cake. It was just so pressed in there. So for fairly for money straight away, that's a good buy. Packed very easily, and this is straight out of the tin, and that seems to be pretty... The cherry light's not the best there. But... Very nice. I'd say the strength of that straight off is medium. The taste being medium to full actually. Room note, can't tell just yet. This is the first smoke I've had of this. Definitely smokes cool. The first light, this seems like a standard lit Kia blend. I can always taste these Oriental and Virginias coming through, and that's sweetening it up and adding a bit of spice. It's more interesting than a straight lit blend. Which is good. Nice full flavour and aroma, and this would satisfy any English smoker. It's leaving just a subtle, tangy, almost a floral aftertaste on the palate. Very nice. Anyway, bear with, and I'm going to smoke this down a wee bit more, and I'll come back with a final review on it. See you soon. I'm back again. So smooth, it's beautiful. The full flavour just develops more as the bowl came down. Smoke the bowl down. It's going to be an easy all day smoke. Good quality tobacco. I would say that was low on the nicotine count, which is, suits me fine. Nice retrohale. I like it a lot. First impressions. Smoke it in this particular pipe. It's reasonably, it's almost acorn, this one. Even the chamber comes down the shape of that pipe there as well, but I'll try this in some bigger bowls, I think. That's nice, and I'm going to give that 4.5 out of 5. It's pretty high for me, and it's up there with my more favoured tobacco so far to date. Very nice. I was just reading in a little bulletin paper here recently, it was just sort of interesting facts and factoids and whatever, but it was, they were mentioning about O.J. Simpson. And how he was originally cast as the Terminator, but the studio ditched him because they were afraid that he, the public, wouldn't be able to take him seriously as a remorseless killer. Hindsight's a funny thing. Also, a note which I found interesting, what they were saying about. Leonardo da Vinci, apparently. He could write with one hand and draw with the other hand. which I find quite remarkable, but he could actually write with one hand, draw with the other hand at the same time. That's not normal. How could you possibly even do that? And on the last note was a mosquito. I don't see many of those around here. They're talking about the last man to walk on the moon. Was Gene, I can't remember his last name, yeah, Sermon or something like that. And he promised his daughter that he would write her initials on the moon's surface when he was there, which he did, and they were TDC. But I was just thinking, you know, they're going to last there for perhaps the next tens of thousands of years. And kind of think that's some pretty serious graffiti right there. Anyway, you. Balkan Sasieni. Give this a try. It's, I think if you love English or love a cool smoke, great all day smoke. Really nice English, but with a bit of a twist. Really like it. And value for money, it's bang on. I'll be getting a few more of these and perhaps sell them down. Really like that cake almost. Not, I should keep saying cake, but you've seen it yourself. It was really packed in there. So by the time I fluff that out, stick it in some mason jars, it's going to be a good amount. Although I said it goes off weight, but just. Anyway, YouTube. Lovely day here. I'm going to enjoy the last of this bowl. You enjoy the last of your day, wherever you are, and keep them smoky, and as always, English.
Rubber bellies in the back, sweet singers in the front, cruising down the freeway in the hot, hot sun. Suddenly red blue lights flash us from behind. Loud voice booming, please step out onto the line. Ballet bridge was a comfort, Cena just hides her eyes. Policeman taps the shades, is that a Chevy 69? How bizarre.